Mr. David Foster is a 15-time Grammy winner. Why? I'll tell you why. He has worked with the greats. You've heard his music so many times you don't even know it yet. And I must brag about him. Listen to what's going on in this man's life. Hitman, David Foster and Friends. It's a CD, DVD, two discs in one case, in stores now. Hitman, David Foster and Friends, going on a U.S. tour starting April 29th, to be exact. Look, he is unfazed by his own genius. Look at him there. Sitting there. Hitman, David Foster and Friends, great performances on PBS, airs in the beginning of December. Why? So much attention for this one man? Because he deserves it. Let me ask you this. Josh Groban, right? Mm-hmm. Celine Dion. Mm-hmm. This beautiful and talented young woman, Charice. How is it that you find a way to succeed with so many different types of people?
Maybe it's my upbringing, Chris. You know, I grew up on Vancouver Island, and we sort of, as Canadians, had to like work twice as hard to be taken half as seriously. So you kind of learned a lot. I studied classical music. Then I was in Chuck Berry's band when I was 16. So I went from classical to rock and roll all before I was even really ready for the world. And I don't know. I love all kinds of music. And you see somebody like Charice, it's just undeniable. I mean, I just can't wait to make a record with this girl. I'm excited. I'm always excited.
Is there a sensation? Is there something that you can identify that you feel inside that sparks a creative process once you know who you're going to be with?
Well, you know, I love to say about stars per se, and I've worked with a lot of them, is that you sort of feel they're in the room when they show up, even if you don't see them, and you know they've gone, even though you don't see them leave. And this one's got that, like, in an amazing abundance. You know, when you feel Charice come into the room, then when she sings, it's like icing on the cake. And she's also got a great memory. We had changed the arrangement last minute, and she got it. You would probably not be able to do that, Chris, if I changed the arrangement on you.
I cannot read the words on the teleprompter accurately, consistently, but that's why I do what
I
do.
I like you talking about me rather than me talking about
you. It is nice.
Yeah,
I like talking to you, so it's easy. I got a lot to say. Now, let me ask you this. When you had David Foster come, you knew that you were going to combine. What did you think of that?
I think it's amazing because, well, working with him, you know, he's very funny and very comfortable to work with. He's like my dad. Hey, dad.
I like this. That's
more like your grandfather, but that's okay. No, but I can still make music.
You don't look old.
Well, you know, Charice actually in the Philippines sang a lot of the songs that I wrote and produced, so she was very familiar with my music, with perhaps not knowing my name.
When did you first love to sing? How young? 16 now. When did it start?
I started to sing when I was 4.
4 years old.
Yeah.
And when was it that people started saying to you, wow, you're really good?
I started to join singing contests when I was 7. Then
lost, right?
Yeah, I lost in the Philippines. And then he discovered me in YouTube.
The YouTube?
Yeah, with a little help from Oprah.
It's kind of cheating. I'm making you out to be this creative genius, and then you're on YouTube. Where's the inspiration?
Well,
where's the spark? You talk about Vancouver.
You're reading cue cards. I'm talking without cue cards, okay? Who's the genius?
That's true. Fair point. Fair point. Fair point. The song we're going to hear now, I Will Survive. Mr. Foster, young Charice, take it away. Pleasure.
Thanks, Chris.
So many